Welcome to another SMC technical training video. In this video, we will show you how to use an add-on profile or a generic Ethernet module so that your PLC can control an Ethernet IP EX260. During the video, we will show you the equipment, software, and the steps required. In the end, the PLC will be able to control an actuator through the EX260. Let's get started. These are the parts and tools that you will need to use to set up the EX260 in this video. You'll need a PC, software, and Ethernet connectivity for communication as well. To see how the equipment was set up, please review the original hardware setup video. Also, check out the updated equipment IP address settings video before proceeding with this one. First, hook up the actuator to the manifold. Turn on power to the EX260 and turn on your air source. Test the actuators with the manual overrides. Now, let's set up the EX260 module for the PLC. The first way to add the Ethernet module to the PLC is by using Rockwell add-on profile. Download and unzip the add-on profile files for the EX260 to a folder. Check the instruction and operation manuals page for more information. We've established communication with the two devices. Now we're ready to map the EX260 to the PLC. We've created a program using Studio 5000 and given it a name. On the left side under the controller organizer, go ahead and right-click on Ethernet and tell it you want to create a new module. We use these filters to remove everything except for SMC devices, making it easier to select the EX260. Click Create. Then, give it first the name, then the IP address connected to, and finally click Change, and go to Revision 2.3, then choose Compatible Module or Disable Keying as they apply. Click OK. We've now mapped the device, and we're ready to download this into the PLC and get the actuator going. The second way to set up the EX260 is with a generic Ethernet module. Select Ethernet in the controller organizer, then right-click and select New Module. In the Select Module Type table, select Generic Ethernet Module and click Create. In the New Module Type, enter the desired unit name first, then enter the Datacom format type, and then the IP address that was set for the unit. Finally, enter the assembly instance and size. These are fixed for the EX260, dependent upon the data type and the unit in use. We've mapped the EX260 into the PLC, so we're ready to use it as I/O. We'll go into the controller tags, and you'll notice that the program has already created tags called EX260I and EX260O. Now what we're looking for is the outputs, and these will actually be what connects up to our solenoid valves. Create a couple of tags. For example, the first would be called extend, and we'll give it an alias, assign it to the output, and then we'll call the valve's other movement retract, and assign that to the next output. These are just I/O points to be driven directly out of the EX260. Now we'll save that, then go into WhoActive, then highlight and download them into the PLC. Make sure that you follow the screen to complete the download. Now, switch the processor into run mode. Now we will actuate the solenoid bits by changing their values in the extend and retract value table. And as we change the bits per station, the actuator is moving as per the associated solenoid signal. We hope you found this video useful. Look for other SMC technical training videos to assist you in learning about and using our other automation products.